Hello again and welcome to the inside of my car. It's been a long time since I did a review in my car, and I did it for a reason, and I'll explain once I get into this movie review. The movie that I witnessed today with a very good friend of mine who just stopped into town and we caught a small foreign language film. It is from the country of Chile, and it is called Gloria. I've been wanting to see this movie for a very long time. I saw the trailer about 3 or 4 months ago, and it just looked really cool, looked really interesting. And probably for most people that are outside the country, it might be a 2013 film, but for me, it will be a 2014 film. It did not get nominated for the Oscars, though I hear it was in the competition to be nominated, but it did not get nominated. And it's getting a lot of wonderful buzz, so I was very excited to see it tonight. And the reason that I'm in my car right now and doing the review is, yeah, I'm pretty lazy and I had a lot of other exciting things happen to me tonight that I'm not going to go into great detail. But I wanted to shoot my review in my car because the main character to this film, Gloria, drives around and owns my car, pretty much. The same model, make and model. It's hilarious. And I want you to see the movie so you can find out what kind of car I drive if you don't really know. If you know me, you're a friend, and you know me personally, you might know what kind of car I drive. But for everybody else, I would rather you go see this movie because this is a very, very special film. It's a film that really surprised me, and like Blue is the Warmest Color, there was one really major aspect that I really liked. In Blue is the Warmest Color, there is really no musical score written for the film. There might be some source music, but like that film, there's no musical score in this entire film. It is some source music from here and there. It's all natural. It's like when they're eating at dinner, the music is coming out and they're listening to it, and so are we for the first time. So this movie is from the country of Chile, as I said before. Focus, everybody. my camera. So if it comes in and out of focus, I apologize. So yeah, this movie is centered in the country of Chile. It's about an older woman. She's probably in her late 50s, early 60s. And she loves life. She has a very successful job. She is divorced. She's been divorced for probably about 13 years. She does have a somewhat, you know, friendship relationship with her ex-husband, but she's more close to her kids. And, you know, she's a very positive person, goes out and mingles with the world, and you know, she has some friends. But when one of her occasions where she's going to like this social event for older people, she runs into this gentleman who's just a really nice guy and really tends to really care for her. But he's got some major issues where he's dealing with his kids who are in their late 20s, early 30s, and they're just really dependent on him. And even an ex-wife, I believe it was an ex-wife, she is very dependent on him as well. So Gloria is not really getting, you know, one minute she's having the time of her life with this gentleman, and the next minute he's disappeared. And there was a couple times where I was like, where did he go? What happened to him? Like, when Gloria's like this, I'm like, what happened to him? Wait, what? He's gone? Why? Oh, frustrating. But, yeah, that's kind of the plot of the movie. It's a great film. This is a fabulous foreign language film. I didn't mind reading subtitles. I actually prefer when I go see a foreign language film that I have to read. I'm glad I don't know the language, so I can, you know, read along and I get so much more out of it. And it didn't take away from my experience because the acting by Paulina Garcia, I believe that's her name, the main star of the film, she's fabulous and gives an award-winning performance. I think she won an award in some festivals for Best Actress, and she'll probably win some awards in her native country. She gives a fabulous job. It's a great-looking film. It moves. It's entertaining. There's some incidents that she has with her neighbor and their neighbor's cat that are really funny and poignant and sad at the same time. But this is a happy, sad, honest film that's told honestly. That was the most amazing how honest it felt. And I think that helped that there wasn't a musical score. Even though I love soundtracks, I love to collect movie scores, but sometimes I like when a filmmaker can do all this great magic without telling me how to feel. It's amazing, and I really enjoyed this movie a lot. It's an incredible film. It's definitely one of the better films that I've saw in 2014 so far, and it's definitely something that's worth seeing. Man, I'm only coming out of focus back and forth. I hate that. I apologize again for that, but thank you for sticking around and enjoying this review. If you can find Gloria at your local theater, we had to go to a smaller theater near Los Angeles to go check out the film. But if you can find Gloria, I do recommend it. I give the film Gloria 3.5 stars out of 4. I'm Movie Man Chat. Please like, comment, subscribe to my channel. I'm also on Twitter and I'm on Facebook. And please go to WeLiveFilm.com and subscribe right here on YouTube to We Live Film. And also go to Long Beach Acting and Film Association right here on Facebook and Twitter. And if you've enjoyed this review, please click right here and subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you so much for watching. And I look forward to seeing more foreign language films in 2014. Because reading subtitles is awesome. Thank you again for watching. Have a great night and peace be with you, my friends. Later.
Peace.